You think of Paris, you think of the Eiffel Tower. I'm getting out of breath.
Oh, look at him go. Go on, lassie.
Never again. One and done.
Look, there's a regular human, and there's the Mona Lisa. Good morning. We're about to go into Paris. Have a look around. The Eiffel Tower, the Arc de Triomphe. But we're starting our day at Aldi, a nice German supermarket in the middle of France. Because we're gonna get a packed lunch, save a bit of money. That's how it works. We don't wanna be eating and surviving on frogs, legs, and snails. Now, that did happen before. We're driving around for an hour, and then I ended up having snails, but not this time. And I come prepared. Okay, let's go. Okay, we're ready to explore.
Yeah.
Let's go. Okay, we wanna go. Where are we going? Eiffel Tower? Wow, look at that. All right, let's go. Here we are, we're off the train. Look what's in front of us. Wow, Arc de Triomphe. Looks nice, doesn't it? I remember the first time I drove to Paris. I drove here back in 2010, I think it was. First time driving on the right side of the road. I drove all the way to Paris. And then I came to this roundabout here. This roundabout, there's no lane markings, there's no rules. Maybe there are rules, but they're not very obvious. Look. Today there's no car. Today we left the car, we got the train, so it feels a bit better. But the rules for getting to the middle, I have no idea. I just run really fast.
Check it out.
Wow. Looks amazing, doesn't it? Look at that. Look at this. She's trying to pose for the photo, but she doesn't realize I'm taking a video. Look at that. The Arc de Triomphe. A memorial. The French Revolutionary Wars and the Napoleonic Wars. Inside, look, you have all the names of the generals and various people. There's actually a lot of names in here. Look at that. A memorial. A grand memorial. You can actually pay to go at the top as well. But what's underneath? Look, a tomb of the unknown soldier from the First World War. And there's a couple of pigeons. Look at that. Amazing. Wow, pretty cool, isn't it? So, very nice arc. By the way, if you want to get over here, the last time I ran off the road, but there's actually an underground entrance, so I recommend that one. But the next stop, look at that little guy there. Let's check it out. There she blows. Look at that. The Eiffel Tower. Tour de Eiffel. Look at him go there. Made by Mr. Eiffel himself. He's a very nice guy. Well, I'm sure he was. Just next to the Eiffel Tower now. Things have changed. Prices are different. Yeah, there we go. To the top and then to the second floor there. So today we're lucky because we can get this price because, well, check it out. Okay, let's see. No, worse. Look worse. Yeah, there you go. Okay, perfect. Never gonna work. So, one thing I noticed, very hard to find a toilet. I mean, very hard. We found one toilet, one literal toilet, way over there in the bushes. It's a huge long queue, huge long line. Nothing else in this whole area. The Eiffel Tower, the place that gets like
5 million tourists a year to go up the tower. One toilet. Unbelievable. Yeah, so I went in the bushes. What I found in the bushes was... Everyone's obviously going in the bushes, but... oh, it stinks. Paris, get more toilets. Anyway. Look at that. Have a look around anyway. So there's a huge dirt area here. It's not really grass, it's just kind of like this. You can walk around, take pictures of the tower. The other side I think looks a lot nicer. It has stairs and things, but we're going to check that out in a minute. She's looking for a tactical place to go pee-pee. So we're about to climb the Eiffel Tower. What you see a lot of around here is people selling little trinkets. They sell them on the floor, make a euro or two. But the police are very on it. They tie a lot of the things with strings and make a quick getaway. But yeah, you'll see that a lot around here. But if you do want to buy, I think 4 little Eiffel Towers for 1 euro is quite reasonable. But yeah, little tip. But don't pay like 20, it's... Anyway, we're gonna climb the tower. We're underneath the Eiffel Tower. Check it out, look. Crazy. It's good, isn't it? Yeah, they closed the top floor. They said there's too many people there. So plan in advance. It used to be the tallest building in the whole world for about 40 years. I think until the 1930s. Now it's a little twig in comparison to the Burj and everything else. Really, is Tower 42 higher? I don't know. Anyway, not important. We're here. So we're gonna see if we can get up. Maybe get up the stairs. Wow, restaurants under. Even lakes with ducks. Look at that. I remember last time I was here, if you want to take the stairs, it's a lot quicker. There's a lot less people waiting. Maybe you get up slower, I don't know, but in the long run it could be even. But yeah, stairs, cheaper, less waiting. No messing around, right? So look, you can take the stairs this far, but you can't take the stairs the rest of the way. So we're gonna go right here. Okay, the ascent has begun on the Tower de Eiffel. We have a long way to go. Look at our journey. Wow. We might be in a little bit of trouble. What do you think?
I'm not gonna make No, I'm gonna try. It's okay. We have a new challenge.
We have a new challenge.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go. So Eiffel Tower, I don't know much about it, other than the bit I said before about it being the tallest building. I think it was like the centerpiece of the World's Fair when it was first built. I think the company that did the construction, I think Gustave Eiffel was either the owner or the main kind of guy that coordinated everything and built the tower. I remember a lot of people criticizing it, saying, this is not art, no. But over the years, it's one of the most famous landmarks in the world. One of the most popular ticketed destinations, attractions. Yeah, and here it is today. You think of France, you think of Paris, you think of the Eiffel Tower. I'm getting out of breath. Look at that.
I'm training for the next 2 months.
Yeah. We have a long way up. So I don't remember the security wall being here before. Before, I remember walking freely underneath. I could be remembering wrong, but yeah, you go through the security, And then you can go under the tower, you don't need to pay anything. You only begin to pay when you want to climb the tower. So anyone can come in. They didn't seem really concerned about, you know, like weapons and drugs. They just wanted to know if I had any alcohol. I said no, only cocaine and nuts.
That's true.
Look at that. We'll get a better look at the top, I'm sure. Wow. All right, we'll resume when we get up. Welcome to the first floor. It wasn't too bad, actually. Oh, did like 2 minutes? And look at that view. That's where we were earlier. That was the only toilet I could find in those trees. Otherwise, I didn't go in the tree. It was an actual toilet. But yeah, look at that. Here's the first floor. Wow. Looks pretty cool, doesn't it? And there's some old stairs. Look at that. But yeah, look up here too. Wow. So, before we resume the stairs, let's take a look around. Ah, yes. You can get...
No!
You can get a German pretzel, which I'm sure is French. I'm sure it's a French-German pretzel in the Eiffel Tower. Commercialism. Fan escaping. Okay. Wow. Look at that, look. There he is, look. Mr. Gustave Eiffel. Look how proud he looks, look. Look at him. Yeah, he knows he did a good job. Look at that. Wow. TV is indoors now. TV is indoors. I assume you get a free elevator on the way down either way, right? I don't remember, it's been so long. Oh, look at this. Oh, no. Oh, that's weird. You can lean on the glass. Oh, it feels weird. Wow, look at that. That's pretty cool. Panoramic. Ooh. Monty. Secret door. Look at this. Nice view of the city. Pretty cool. Wow. Looks pretty nice. I don't remember this at all. Last time I came here was, I think, 10 years ago. But it's probably just my memory. I have a bad memory. Wow. Alright, I think we might... start heading up to the next floor. So we have two floors of stairs, and then we have an elevator. Wow. It just smells of pastry, croissants and pretzels. Look at that. Wonder how much a beer is here. Let's go check. Might be interesting to know. There you go, look. Alright, heading up to the second floor now. Wait, that must be for the elevator, look. Wow. It's pretty cool. A lot of stairs. So, welcome to the second floor. Look at this, another cafe, but still a little ways to go. But look how high we are. It's pretty cool, isn't it? We're already higher than most buildings on this floor. It's amazing, right?
Oh.
So that's the summit, look.
little bit further, then we have the elevator. But have a look at Paris, look. I'm sure we'll get these views again at the top, but there's the river. There's someone doing a river tour. Maybe they're having a cheeky meal as well. It's all right, isn't it? Yeah, well, good old Gustave. He didn't do too bad, did he? Good old Gustave. What's in here? Oh, that's where we get... we can go down on the elevator. Alright, I think it might be time for the top. Oh, I like how you can see the kind of internal structures. You can't get too close, but you can see the elevator whizzing by sometimes. Pretty nice. Might actually have a toilet in here, I didn't think about it. Yeah, look at that! Wow, it's like gold dust. Wow. I'd come here just for the toilet.
I heard you.
Amazing, isn't it? This is what you see when you're waiting for the elevator. Oh, there it is, look. There's the elevator. Check that out. Wow, this is turning into a little bit of a nightmare, not gonna lie. It's crazy busy. There's people getting angry because there's so many people. There's babies crying. Woo! I'll be glad when I'm done now, I think. It's too busy. I think maybe try night time or in the morning. I think 6 p.m. No bueno. But maybe the top is better. It's a lot of people. Look at this. It feels like being back at Disneyland. Look, there's the queue for the summit. I'm not sure where it begins. At least we have some nice views. Or we can use this. Look, it just cost a couple euros. Oh my god. We've almost made it. There's actually another line over there. And here's the line we almost have just finished. It's never again. One and done. Last time I was here I never did the elevator, just the stairs. But one and done, one and done. Do you wanna be a sardine? A sardine in a can, well then you have to pay. Here we go. Let's go. Oh, yes. Oh, let's go. Oh, all the way. I have to.
I'm going all the way.
Wow. He's chilling, look, chilling on his phone. Oh, there are stairs. I guess people just can't go on them. Oh no? Oh. Wow. Palms are weak. Or is it her knees weak, palms are heavy? Yeah, mum's spaghetti. I feel some mum's spaghetti coming up now. It's pretty high. Oh my god. Jesus. Oh, it's stopping. God. I feel sick. Yes, sir. Merci. We're here. Oh, I'm not gonna lie, I found my dinner coming up. Oh, it's high. And the floor is made of this metal that's kind of tacked on, so the floor kind of does this and it gives you the feeling of sweat hole, swaying and all kinds of things. Look out the window, look. Look at that. That's pretty much the view all the way along. The windows are a bit dirty, but you get the idea, right? Wow.
Oh, there's Wild Bill.
There's little things here, though.
Buffalo Bill.
Various bits of information. I wonder how much people are paid to clean these windows on the outside. Oh, wow. Oh,
look at that.
Can you go upstairs? Maybe. Maybe there's more. Look at that. Imagine getting a job in the elevator, you're just up and down all day. Free rides to the top every time. It's good, isn't it? Wow. It's Jason Statham. Look at this. Wow. There it is, look. Ah, Le Paris. Le Paris. Wow. What do you think? It's good, isn't it? You're gonna puke? Yeah, I was feeling the same. Look at all the concrete.
I feel tickles in my stomach.
It looks like ancient Greece from far away. When you get close, then it's fancy again. Amazing, isn't it? Unbelievable. And here's what it looks like. Let's have a little look around. See what we can find. Another telescope. I wonder if they're the 4 euro telescopes. Who knows? Wow. So, there is a little bit of a higher bit, but I think you need special privileges. But there is a champagne bar. Maybe people get married here. Check it out, look. Champagne and caviar. Oh, you had caviar. Give me my fish eggs. Oh, wow, look at that, oh, fancy. Look at him, a fancy Frenchman selling champagne. Wow. It's good, isn't it? Wow, Eiffel Tower, the top. Do they have a toilet though? That's the question. Look at this plaque here. Look at that, 1944. Wow. What do you think?
It's a good view.
It's a good view, yes. I think that means you're scared. Yes, okay. That's translated from Peruvian. Well, here it is, Paris. Paris in the summer. Little boat, look. I think that driver's drunk. What are you doing? Look at him. He's a drunk driver, look. He's had too many champagnes. Wow. You're drunk. Look at this. Or maybe look at that. Or look at that. Ah, there he is, look. Gustave. Which one's Gustave? Is that him in the black? Or is it him in the grey? Now he looks like the host, it must be him. And there's his girlfriend or wife or something. Pretty cool, isn't it? Look at that. Wow. Amazing. So we're just queuing to get back down on the elevator now. It's a lot quicker going down. It's a lot longer going up. But it concludes our tour of the Eiffel Tower. Is it worth it? I'm still not sure. But you've seen it for yourself now, so you can just say. Get the free elevator back down. The free big rickety elevator. Just enjoying a nice casual ring sausage. Definitely not getting any looks. Pretty good actually. She even got the string on, look at that.
Yeah, it's cool.
Having a nice little rocket and pepperoni baguette. We've got a different, what are you doing in there?
My thumb.
Oh, you're opening it up. Yeah. That's Peruvian style baguette. This is a British style baguette. Look at that. Paris at sunset. Look at that, everyone leaving work, looking their cars. Traveling along an arched bridge. Wow. But where are we going? Well, we're going through this archway. Who knows what's on the other side? But let's find out. Might be something exciting. Look at these cobbled streets as well. Some house.
Where?
There. Look. Tom Hanks in the Da Vinci Code, just around the corner. Look at that. Pyramidi.
No entiendo, te la mierda.
You can't please some people. Hey, what about Notre Dame?
Okay.
I don't know if that's Notre Dame, I'll have to double check. But look at that. So here we are. We're at a very special place. A special place where Tom Hanks in the Da Vinci Code. He solved the mystery, sought out the secret of the Templars, and whatever else. It was a long time ago, I don't remember. What do you think? Tom Hanks. Look at that. The Louvre, the home, the Casa de Mona Lisa lives inside. But we have a problem because on the first Friday of every month, Friday, September the 21st, it's free entry. But free entry means it's probably way too busy and the line is too long. But we're gonna find out, see what happens, and then go from there. I think it shuts at 9:45, so we have an hour 45 to make something happen. Oh, there are those sellers I was telling you about, look. Look at that, look. So they'll be selling those things pretty cheap, and then they'll, pull them away when the police arrive. So they're always on guard.
I'm just trying to save your bag of the pickpocket.
Oh yeah, thank you. She's my pickpocket watch lookout, yes. What do you think of the pyramid?
Speaking.
Yeah? Tom Hanks?
¿Me tienes hasta los huevos con tu Tom?
Tom Hanks?
No, cállate.
Okay. Can't please everyone. Oh, look at him go. Go on, Lassie. Go on, Lassie. Go on, Lassie. Run away. Be free. Lassie, what are you doing? It's not coming out. Oh, he thinks he's playing with them, look. Oh no, oh, you're in trouble now. Oh, go! Lassie wins again. We're inside the Louvre. We just cleared security. Pretty weak security, we have our drinks and everything. So if you want to bring a snack, I think it's okay. And now we're going underground to see what we can find. Oh. Freebie Friday. Hey. Wow. If these walls could talk, eh? If these walls could talk. Wow. Amazing, really. Check it out. Wow. Now the camera doesn't do it justice, but look at that amazement. I think that's the Peruvian face of amazement. I'm not sure. Look at this. It's just endless paintings. We're in the Italian wing right now, but look. Amazing. Wow. It's unbelievable, really. I'm getting memories of when I went to Vatican City, and it was pretty much like one huge art gallery, just a long corridor, painting, painting, painting. You get a bit spoiled because there's so many paintings, you don't really know which one to stop and look at. And then the ceilings, again, paintings all the way along. It's just, you could spend a week in here and only be half done. Yeah, it's absolutely mad. And this is all Italian works from various time periods. Obviously, Mona Lisa being the prized of the collection from the Renaissance. But, I mean, it's absolutely mad. Look at this.
Be
courteous. Oh, there it is, look. Look at that. You know what I find really funny? Is Leonardo da Vinci, he paints the Mona Lisa. You know, everyone's seen the Mona Lisa, right? Look at that. And then someone does this, and it's not as popular. I don't understand art, but that's mad. So, everyone's here for the Mona Lisa, look at them. Mad, isn't it? It's actually a lot smaller than I thought it was. Look, there's a regular human, and there's the Mona Lisa. Huh. That's interesting, isn't it? I'm not sure what I expected, but there it is. Mona Lisa. And there's everyone looking at the Mona Lisa. And there's even me with the Mona Lisa. Wow. Good morning. Bye, Mona Lisa. It's been a pleasure. Had to go. So, the Mona Lisa. Leonardo da Vinci, he started on it in Italy, and then he moved to France. I think it was King Francis of France. He invited him over. He said, hey, Leonardo, get over here, do some work for me, you know? It'll be great. He packs up his stuff. He moves with his little buddy, his little mate, goes to France, starts working for old Francis. There, he finishes the Mona Lisa, and then not long after, dead. Through the French Revolution and everything else, the Mona Lisa survived. It survived in France. It was put up in the palace, I think, for around 100 years and moved to the Louvre. And it's been here ever since. It's actually been stolen once, I think early 1900s. I think they found it in the guy's car boot or something. I don't remember. It's been a long time since I learned about it. But yeah, quite a big history. It's one of the most valuable paintings in the world. I think it was insured for around what would be... lots of billion today anyway, but merci, thank you. Drop my glasses. Yeah, absolutely crazy. So we finally seen it, we saw it for free, and the queues weren't that long. So when I saw the Last Supper in Italy, that was more underwhelming than seeing the Mona Lisa, because it's been touched up so many times. There's a lot of debate whether the original is still, you know, really there anymore. And I think it was damaged as well. But when we're in there, like, no photography, no videos, and you only have a little bit of time in the room, and if you want to see it, you have to pay a lot of money. So I think the Mona Lisa, a lot better of an experience than the Last Supper. But they're my only two experiences with Italian artwork anyway. So we're going to check out Old Venus, huh? And see what she's up. So here's the other one, as anyone that doesn't know much about art would say. The Venus de Milo, check it out. Wow, you can see it's a lot less busy than the Mona Lisa. It's It's a little room, three guys chilling out in the corner, monitoring things. It's not bad, is it? It's pretty nice floor as well, lots of various Greek statues. That's pretty cool, look at that. Wow. It was actually rediscovered in the early 1800s. And legend has it, they lost the original base. That's why it doesn't really look very matching, you see? It's a lot darker. I think they lost that after the rediscovery. I don't really remember. But the arms, wow, arms are lost in time. But look at that, it's cool, isn't it? Wow, Venus. God of love, Roman god of love, but Aphrodite, the Greek god of love. Look at that. Wow. Look. Wow, here we are. Venus de Milo. We're playing copy the statue. Well, that's pretty good. More finger. Yeah. Okay, so we're leaving the Louvre. It's getting late. I feel like you could honestly spend a week here. But because it's free, I don't mind looking at the highlights and having a bit of a laugh then leaving. But absolutely huge. Absolutely huge. All those buildings that were surrounding it, they were part of the gallery. I didn't realize the pyramid was just the entrance. And then, massive. Anyway, onward. Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks moment. I don't know what it is about French toilets. There's always one. There's a giant McDonald's, there'll just be one store. Like here, huge arcade, one room. It's always empty. People's bladders must be like this big. It's like there's no toilet, but no one ever needs to go. It's a mystery. You know, I always find funny. It's probably weird and it's probably just me. But when you buy something like this, you know, it looks a bit phallus-like. And then there's a guy on there. He's like looking very proud. And it just seems... seems a bit weird. And then when you put that one back and go over here, this one's super thick and he has the smuggiest grin. Maybe I'll get some ham instead. Look, she's stealing a turnip from the field. Look at that. Poor farmer working his hardest to grow all these turnips. Unbelievable.